The United Nations Security Council adopted its first binding resolution to expand sanctions on Pyongyang in 4 years for its successful satellite launch on December 12th. South Korea, a new non-permanent member of the council, has pushed for tougher actions on North Korea since the beginning of the month.
The UN Security Council resolution has been adopted unanimously, clearly showing the international community's serious concerns over North Korea's long-range missile. North Korea should faithfully follow its duties as part of the international community and immediately stop nuclear development and long-range missile launches.
North Korea denounced the UN Security Council's condemnation and further stated it would abandon its nuclear program once the world is denuclearized.
North Korea left talks for peace and stability of the Korean Peninsula open, but also vowed to bolster its military capabilities, saying the UN resolution clearly demonstrates Washington's hostile policy towards Pyongyang.
While the United States and its allies considers North Korea's satellite launch to be a ploy to develop ballistic missiles to carry nuclear weapons, Pyongyang claims the launch was a peaceful bid to send a satellite into space. The U.S. has sent a special envoy to South Korea en route to China and Japan to discuss how to move forward on North Korean relations.
Our policy toward North Korea has been the same for quite a while now. It's been a dual-track policy of engagement when possible, pressure when necessary. We are, of course, in a bit of a pressure phase, but I'm here because my role in this as a diplomat representing the United States is to try always creatively to look for ways forward.
Analysts suggest that North Korea's satellite launch was its way of pressuring the U.S.
North Korea contacted the U.S. several times last year in an attempt to talk and change Washington's stance on Pyongyang, though the basic message was delivered. Even after the elections, Pyongyang may have felt Washington's attitude toward them had not changed. From that perspective, they are pressing the U.S. through specific action.
Though China supports the revised resolution, it stressed the importance of dialogue with North Korea and the resumption of the six-party talks, something the U.S. and South Korea have failed to initiate. Joseph Kim, Press TV, Seoul.